This is the Hubble Space Telescope. Packed with advanced optics and sensors, it has wowed us for decades with one breathtaking image after another. Its capabilities are so advanced that even the $10 billion James Webb Telescope serves only to complement Hubble, not to replace it. Hubble is restricted by law from ever turning its gaze towards our planet. That is a job reserved for military hardware, usually the USA's flagship KH-11 spy satellites. Despite being highly classified, the details that we do have give the impression that the Hubble Space Telescope might not have been such a revolutionary development after all. In 2019, Iran unsuccessfully attempted to launch a satellite. Planet Labs Incorporated was the first to release satellite photos of the aftermath. Taken at a resolution of 3 meters, you can definitely tell something went wrong. Later that day, a much better photo was released by Maxar. These photos are extremely useful and they provide plenty of detail as to what happened. Maxar advertises their satellites as providing the highest resolution photos available in the commercial market. But that's the commercial market. The day after the incident, a certain president casually shared a highly classified image. The tweet's focus was on the Iranian explosion, but the world's focus was on the unprecedented glimpse into the top secret imaging capabilities of the US government. Compared to the best photos available from commercial sources, the military's satellite capabilities were clearly generations ahead. We can easily make out words, damaged vehicles, debris, soot, the destroyed Erector Tower, and many other details. To make this even more impressive, the tweeted image was clearly a photo of a photo, likely captured by a phone from a printed copy, meaning the original is probably even more detailed. Internet sleuths quickly got to work picking apart publicly available orbital data to determine that this photo had to be captured by USA 224, which was one of 15 KH-11 class reconnaissance satellites in orbit at the time. The KH-11 itself and the photos that it captures are highly classified, but like the tweeted photo, various details have slipped out over the years, and this brings us back to Hubble. The similarities start out pretty tame. From the start, it was noted that the Hubble Space Telescope used the same shipping crate as the KH-11 satellites, indicating it was probably a similar size.
It was mind-boggling. I envisioned Hubble being big. I did not envision Hubble being huge. And Hubble was huge. Since I had already flown a shuttle mission, I knew how big the shuttle was, and I knew how big the shuttle's payload bay was. Hubble was too big. And the first impression was, how the hell are they gonna fit that in the payload bay? That is a monstrous payload.
NASA had to fight relentlessly to secure funding before they could start building Hubble. In 1974, Congress cut all funding for the project, and it took 4 years of lobbying before NASA eventually managed to secure half of the requested amount for the telescope. This budget cut meant Hubble would have to be scaled back, and our next clue comes from the announcement that Hubble would use a 2.4 meter mirror instead of the originally planned 3 meter mirror. NASA stated, "In addition, changing to a 2.4 meter mirror would lessen fabrication costs by using manufactured technologies developed for military spy satellites." Later, the CIA confirmed that Hubble's mirror was finished on the same equipment as the reconnaissance telescopes. Hubble was manufactured by Lockheed Martin at their facility in Sunnyvale, California. The KH-11 satellites were built at the exact same location. This photo is of USA-129, an older KH-11 spy satellite launched in 1996. The fact that an amateur astrophotographer captured this photo from the ground is impressive, even if the result doesn't reveal much. However, when placed next to a rendering of the Hubble Space Telescope, it's not difficult to imagine that they might be similar.
Imagine the Hubble Space Telescope, except pointing down.
Hubble remains NASA's most expensive project in history, and to this day, the launch of that single telescope is widely regarded as a remarkable feat of science and engineering that pushed our ability to understand the universe farther than ever before. But for some contrast, the United States has launched 19 KH-11 satellites over the years, at least some of which are confirmed to be even more advanced than Hubble. It's not hard to see how this would be possible when we look at budget allocations. In 2022, NASA received a budget increase of 3% for a total of $24 billion. By contrast, the National and Military Intelligence Programs received a total of just under $90 billion. One particular story emphasizes this vast difference in funding. NASA would always benefit from building far more probes and satellites than what is possible with their limited budget. So, in 2011, the National Reconnaissance Office reached out to NASA to donate two full space telescopes, each valued at a minimum of $250 million, along with a mirror and other parts for a third telescope. The associated reconnaissance projects had been canceled, and the NRO considered this technology from the 1990s to be obsolete at this point. On the other hand, NASA scientists were stoked to receive them and went on to describe them as a substantial improvement over the Hubble Space Telescope. This tells us a lot about just how advanced spy telescopes are compared to the ones built for pure science. Details of the donated hardware give us even more insight. At 2.4 meters, the primary mirrors are identical in size and quality to the one used by Hubble, confirming that the telescope is based on upcycled spy satellite optics.
This special mirror, 2.4 meters of specially ground glass designed to capture the light of the universe back in time, billions of years.
But these newer mirrors had integrated mechanisms to allow the secondary mirror to be precisely steered, explaining the apparent ability of KH-11 satellites to take pictures at surprisingly steep angles. There were other noticeable differences as well. The donated telescopes had a significantly shorter focal length, providing a much wider field of view. This makes sense considering spy satellites have no need to peer all the way across the universe. Based on these differences, scientists nicknamed these repurposed telescopes as stubby Hubbles. No pictures were ever released, but NASA scientists described the donated telescopes as looking just like a blunt-length version of the Hubble Space Telescope, down to its signature Mylar exterior and solar panel mounts.
I certainly remember the very first time I went into the enormous clean room where Hubble was being built. I mean, it's 90 feet tall and 120 feet long. And hyper clean air. And the telescope it just looked like something Tiffany's had built. Just glistening silver, fabulous, gorgeous piece of work, huge.
Going back to the amateur photo, a shorter version of Hubble seems like a fitting description. NASA is still pondering what exactly to do with these donated stout Hubbles. The shorter focal length has led to talk of creating a highly advanced Mars orbiter that would be capable of a 100-fold improvement in surface picture resolution over the current Mars orbiter. It would also be a perfect upgrade for the WFIRST satellite set to launch in 2027. WFIRST is also known as the Nancy Grace Roman Space Telescope, named after, no, not that Nancy Grace. This one, Nancy Grace Roman, accomplished astronomer and NASA's first chief of astronomy. Due to her critical role in planning the Hubble project, she became known as the mother of Hubble.
The first reference I'm aware of is back in 1925 that was suggested that we needed a telescope in space. I've read that one of the astronomers at Princeton, this was probably in the 30s or 40s, said that when he died, he wanted to go to heaven and take a telescope with him. And so when the possibility of a telescope in space opened up, astronomers jumped on the idea.
NASA had already selected the mirrors to use for this project, but the new mirrors provided by the NRO would yield a 4x improvement in resolution over the planned mirrors. This would provide improved odds of success in the WFIRST goal of studying dark energy. So while specific details will seemingly remain classified for the foreseeable future, evidence seems to suggest that the US government has deployed at least 19 shorter versions of the Hubble Space Telescope over the years as KH-11 surveillance satellites. The newer versions also seem to be even more sophisticated than Hubble, with multiple mentions of upgraded mirrors of around 3 meters in size compared to Hubble's 2.4 meter mirror. But it also seems much more accurate to say that the Hubble Space Telescope isn't so much a revolutionary satellite purpose-built for space exploration as it is most likely an elongated repurposed spy satellite that has been tweaked and modified to produce wonderful photographs like these. The intelligence agencies certainly aren't lagging behind NASA's technologies in any way, and much like Hubble uses more than just optical sensors to study the universe, the government is far from limited to visible light when collecting intelligence. When the darkness of night and dense cloud cover obscures visibility, reconnaissance still continues at full speed, using technologies like Synthetic Aperture Radar, or SAP. SAP works using radar instead of light. It blasts one pulse of radio waves after another, mapping the return signals, and the resulting image increases in resolution with each pulse logged as the satellite passes over terrain. This provides a great alternative to optical reconnaissance when conditions don't allow a clear view of the ground. So, what do you think? Is it ridiculous that the military gets funding for 20 plus Hubble grade satellites while NASA is left with scraps? Or is that just a fair price to pay for security? Leave your comments below, but maybe try to remember to be civil. The mentality of "here's my perspective that's different" is how we end up visiting the moon. The mentality of "here's why your perspective is wrong" is how we end up nuking each other into the Stone Age.